Christmas Eve was spent watching my parents get ready for the busyness of Christmas Day, meal prepping and wrapping presents and cleaning the house. It was a really happy chaos. And amongst all of this, popular Christmas carols blasted out from the telly. There was always one that made us stop and sit quietly. That was O Holy Night. What is it about this particular song that rouses something so deep within us? I didn't know it at the time, but O Holy Night actually started as a poem in France, written by a man called Placide Capot. The poem was later put to music by Adolphe Adam at a time when France was experiencing a lot of economic turmoil, and it became popular in the United States when slavery was being challenged. Translated into English, the lyrics stir. Chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Over 160 years later, many of these issues of poverty and inequality and oppression are still present in our world. We long for the words of O Holy Night to come true. Peace, love, and justice for all. But often, we forget that God has given us the gifts and the blessings to help make this possible. Regular people, poets, writers, composers, work together to help share the message of O Holy Night with the world. And Luke's Gospel reminds us that even something extraordinary as the birth of Jesus required an ordinary girl called Mary, who was made extraordinary by God. When I was young, I thought the Christmas story was just about Jesus being born into our world. But now I'm reflecting on the idea that the world is already Jesus. We just need to follow him. My prayer this Christmas Eve is that we think about